Do you have a trail camera and like to make close-up shots like this, but your camera does not capture the animals in focus from a short distance? Most trail cameras are not suitable for close-ups, but there's an easy solution. In this video, I'll show you how to make a clip-on close-up lens with a 3D printer and reading glasses. I often get questions about my close-up lens, so today I'll show you how to make one yourself. I'm making a lens for a Browning trail camera. This is a Browning Recon Force Edge, but the clip-on I'm making today also fits on other Browning cameras with the same casing, like the Recon Force Elite. We're going to make a clip-on that fits over the top of the camera. This is the design. The lens can be screwed on onto the clip-on. This way you can switch between different lenses for different distances, using the same clip-on. But you can also make it a one piece if you prefer. First we need to take the measurements of the camera, to make sure that the clip-on will fit over the camera and a close-up lens covers the camera lens. Next up is the hardest part. My husband was so kind to help me with this. For the digital design he used Tinkercad, a free and easy to use modeling program. It was quite a challenge, but it turned out really well. Now you need to find someone with a 3D printer and ask nicely if you can use it. Maybe that's the hardest part. So here it is. It fits over the camera. And we can screw this part onto the clip. It's still a little rough, so you can file the edges if needed, especially the inside of the lens. We don't want anything blocking the view. For the lens, we use simple reading glasses. We press one of the lenses out. I use 1.0 glasses. These are perfect for a distance of 1 meter between camera and your target. We'll glue this lens on the screwable part, but first we need to adjust the shape. These lenses are made from plastic, so you can simply cut them with scissors. You better wear eye protection when you do this, because the pieces will scatter around. Once you have the right size, you can make the edges a little smoother with a file. When you're happy with your lens, you glue it on the screw-on cap. To make the clip-on fit a little better, you can add some glue on the insides and let this dry. This will give it more grip so it won't move as easily. And that's it! For the best results, it's a good idea to test them out first, with some action figures, pets or something similar. The ideal distance between camera and target depends on the power of the reading glasses you used. This is probably also different for other trail camera brands, or even models of the same brand. Now you just have to find a nice spot where you expect some small critters to visit, or you use it on a feeding table and let the camera work its magic. Once you get used to your new close-up lens, you can make shots like this. And there you go. Thank you for watching. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. And if you want more tips and inspiration for your own trail camera setup, please consider subscribing. Toodles!